In today's video, we're going to discuss how to create graphs from function tables. So the first step here is to complete the function table. So we're given the rule y equals 1 quarter x minus 2. So we first need to find our 4 y values. So we're going to replace everywhere we see x with the x value. So this is going to give us y equals 1 quarter x is negative 5 minus 2. And if I plug that into my calculator, I do the multiplication first. So 1 quarter times negative 5 gives me negative 1.25 minus 2. So I would subtract 2 from that. And my y value is going to be negative 3.25. Okay. And again, I like to kind of split up my work here so I know which work goes with which table value. All right, the second one, I have y equals 1 quarter times negative 4 minus 2. And 1 quarter times negative 4 gives me negative 1. And negative 1 minus 2 is going to be negative 3. Okay, next one is 0. So I'm going to plug in 0. Y equals 1 quarter times 0 minus 2. 1 quarter times 0 is 0. And 0 minus 2 is negative 2. And my last one, I have x equals 3. So that gives me y equals 1 quarter times 3 minus 2. And 1 quarter times 3 gives me 0.75. And then I would subtract 2. And I have y equals negative 1.25. So again, my first step there is to fill out the table. And then step 2 is to plot the points. And the points must create a line this year. And if they don't create a line, you made a mistake. So all of the functions that we're graphing this year are considered linear. They make lines. And again, if it doesn't make a line, then you want to go back and check your work. So these are all going to be my order pairs. The x value is the x value in the order pair, and the y value is the y value in the order pair. I'm just going to take a minute and copy these as ordered pairs. I can also read them off the table. But just so you see, it's literally the same. You just put parentheses around it and put a comma in between, and there's your ordered pair. So my first ordered pair is negative 5, negative 3 and a quarter. So that's going to be a little bit more than negative 3. So that's going to be about right here, negative 3 and a quarter. The second one is negative 4 and then negative 3. It's going to be there. I have 0, negative 2, and 3, negative 1.25. So here's negative 1 and negative 1 and a quarter is there. After you've plotted your points, you want to take some sort of straight edge. Again, your corner of your agenda, corner of a clipboard, corner of a folder, something like that works pretty well. We line it up along our points, and of course it's not going to be exactly a straight line, but as long as it's pretty close, connect them together, and there's the graph of your function. All right, second example, what do I do if a table of values isn't provided? And the answer to that question is you make your own. So you pick the inputs, you show your work, and you determine the output. Okay, so my rule here is y equals 5/3 x minus 3. Now, we want to be smart when we pick our input. We don't want to pick random numbers. If we do a little bit of thought here, this makes plugging in the values a little bit easier. So you need to pick at least 3, and the first one that I always pick is 0. Because when I pick 0, what happens is my first piece of my equation cancels out, it becomes 0. 5/3 times 0 is 0. And that makes for a very nice ordered pair of 0, negative 3 in this case. Makes my work a little bit less difficult. Alright, the next one I'm going to pick, if I have a denominator of 3, a good choice would be to pick 3. So it gives me 5/3 times 3 minus 3. Because when I multiply 5/3 times 3, these two will cancel. So when those cancel, I have 5 minus 3, and that gives me a 2 as my Y value or my output. So my ordered pair would be 3, 2. And then last but not least, I usually take the opposite. So this would be a negative 3. So I have 5/3 times negative 3 minus 3. And what happens here is the denominator cancels with the 3, but I'm left with a negative. So this is going to be negative 5 minus 3. And that's going to give me a negative 8. So my ordered pair would be negative 3, negative 8. So then I'll go ahead and plot those three points, 0, negative 3. So 0 left to right, down to negative 3, over to 3, and then up to 2. And then negative 3, negative 8. And it goes off my graph a little bit, so I can just extend my graph down to negative 8. And notice my three points form a line. So probably did that right. And connect my points together. Draw the arrows. And there you go.